Oh, nice of you to join us, Dave.
Sorry, sir.
As I was saying, CID are at this very moment involved in a raid on a suspected crack dealer on the Larkman estate. It would help matters if, for the next hour or so at least, we kept away from the area. We don't want to go blundering in where we're not wanted.
Why don't you just close Sandhill for today and we can all go home?
I heard that, Tony. Now, were there any questions? Good.
What is taking so long?
Oh, perhaps it's jam solid, Gov.
Hang about. Here we go.
What's going on? Sunhill Police.
Oh, right.
Whatever it is you're looking for, he's got nothing to do with it.
And what would we be looking for?
Would you mind stepping back into the room, please, and turning out your pockets?
Come on, mate, you heard what she said.
Your pockets, please.
Look, I can explain myself.
Oh, I'm sure you can. Look, can't we talk about this? I'm just a friend of Sylvie's.
Hey, tell him.
It's true, officer.
Is this your flat?
No, it's my boyfriend's.
Sylvia's a singer. I got friends in the music business, so I popped by. I thought I'd pass on a bit of advice.
At 6 in the morning?
Well, I just come out of a club, ain't I? I mean, there's no law against having an early breakfast, is there?
Would you mind turning out your pockets, please, sir?
Just a bit of laughing gear. You people, you hardly bother about that these days.
What's your name?
Eddie Thompson.
Edward Thompson, I'm arresting you on suspicion of possessing illegal drugs.
Oh, what?
You don't have to say anything unless you wish to do so, but what you say may be given in evidence. Now, do you understand?
You're either too early or we're too late by the looks of it, Gov.
I didn't come here for bicarb and all cans of coke.
There's a bloke downstairs, says he's on a social call.
And?
Well, he had a small amount of dope on him.
Not more dope.
Well, he could be a customer.
Great, so we've got the buyer and the seller and not the goods. Look, just keep looking, lads. I know there's gear here, I can smell it. Bring him in to me, Jim.
Sir.
Hey, Todd. That bloke just ran out of that shop. Where do we know him from?
Toby Lewis. Recognise him a mile off.
Oh, he did a 2-year stretch for crack dealing, didn't he?
Yeah. And arrest.
Give him a tow?
What we will do. Keep our distance so we can find out what he's up to.
Sierra Oscar from Sierra One.
Go ahead, Sierra One.
Yeah, vehicle check on a gold Mercedes.
Come on. I knew this would happen sooner or later.
Relax, it's safe.
Yeah? Well, I've had enough. If you need me, I'll be at my mum's.
Sylvie! Come on. Six of you to bust them out for a bit of dope. I wonder what the taxpayers would say.
Shut it! That's what the taxpayer says.
Right, slow down, don't get too close.
Sierra Oscar 1 from Sierra Oscar receiving.
Yeah, go ahead, Sarge.
Yeah, that check you wanted on the gold Mercedes. Keeper shown as Toby Lewis, 28 Loftus Street, E3. Not reported, lost or stolen.
That's the one that calls. Cheers, Sarge. Hang about. Hey, look, why don't we just give him a tug and be done with it, eh?
Better still, let's see if we can catch him red-handed doing something he oughtn't be doing.
All right, we'll have a try, come on.
Right, if you sign there... and there.
No point starting on Floyd till his brief gets here, is it?
Right, no.
Number 1.
He's probably not out of bed yet.
Lane? Edward Thompson, suspicion of possessing illegal substances.
Date of birth?
May the 30th, 1967.
Address?
Flat 6, Regis Wharf, Elverton Road. Look, you're not seriously going to charge me with a couple of joints worth of dope, are you?
What's on your mind?
I reckon it'd be worth giving this drum a spin, Carl.
Bit trusting, isn't it? He's only a customer.
Yeah, but if we could find anything, even the smallest rock, it might give us some leverage against Floyd.
All right.
Looks like he's headed for St. Hugh's. What do you reckon, Ted?
I reckon it's worth having a word.
I'll keep an eye on a young bloke.
Toby Lewis?
Yes, sir.
Can I see your license, please?
Look, I'm in a hurry. I have work to do.
Oh, yeah? What would that be then, Toby?
Excuse me, are you from Askill Street Cabs?
Yes, madam.
Oh, good. Thank you.
Do you mind?
Nice place you got here, Mr. Thompson. Yeah, mortgage is a bit steep, but you got to have a nice gaff, ain't you?
Well, you bought this place? You're obviously paid well. What do you do for a living?
Financial services.
Do you live alone?
I wouldn't have it any other way. Come and go as I please. Right, I suppose you'd best get started.
The machete-wielding big boys are prowling the estates, and we go in mob-handed after a couple of dope heads.
Well, we did find crack-making equipment.
Not much else from what I hear.
Well, there's Thompson, the white guy we found in the flat. He could be quite useful. If we could put pressure on him, he might point a finger at Floyd.
Yeah, well, don't take too much time over it, Harry. If he doesn't come across, caution him and get him out of here.
I told her, Sylvie, I said you're not going to get anywhere without a decent demo tape.
But you've got friends in the business, yeah?
Well, more friends of friends, really. Guy's a good mixer. Another guy can set her out with some studio times, you know, that sort of thing. All finished, mate?
For the time being.
What now?
Back to Sunhill.
Hey?
Do you think your snouts had a change of heart?
Well, I told Floyd we were coming. I doubt it. He's taken a big enough risk as it is.
Well, he hasn't exactly handed us a top-of-the-range crack dealer, has he?
So I can't help thinking Floyd's a one-man band. Look at him. No steel door, no mobile phone, no flash car.
Well, perhaps he's on the bottom run of a career ladder, eh? Any luck, Jim?
Clean as a whistle.
Well, maybe he is just a friend of Floyd's girlfriend.
Oh, come on, Sarge. Look, he's leading us a dance. I know he is. He's just too much.
Yeah, but he can't charge him with that.
Look, what if him and Elliot have got something going together?
Drug dealers?
Yeah, what if Floyd's dealing off his own bat? He needs cocaine to turn into crack, but he can't go to the same place as the other dealers or else they'll be onto him. But then again, he doesn't need to because Thompson's his source.
Well, it'd be an unusual setup, but it's possible.
Look, if I can put the squeeze on him for long enough, convince him the game's already up, I might be able to get him to cough.
Why would we do the same with Floyd?
In a nutshell, yes, Gov.
Yes!
What's happening, mate? I've been here hours.
You're going to be called for an interview any minute, Mr. Thompson. You're just going to have to be patient.
Interview? I've got things to do, you know. I've got people to see.
So have we. Sorry.
I must remind you, you're still under caution.
Early this morning, we found you in possession of half an ounce of grade one hash. That would seem an awful lot for personal use.
Half an ounce of dope makes me a dealer. Do me a favour.
You must smoke this stuff morning, noon and night.
So go on then. Charge me for it.
We will, unless we can charge you for something bigger, like crack, for example. Well, we found all the right gear. You're not going to deny that, surely?
No comment.
This guy Thompson. Good mate of yours, is he?
He's a mate, yeah.
Where'd you meet him?
Club uptown. He likes hanging out with us, likes the same music. He's all right.
And why was he hanging around your place early this morning?
He was chatting with Sylvie. He says he's got friends in the music business who could help her with her singing career.
I think he might have been around here for another reason.
Like what?
I don't know. Maybe he popped in to buy something.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Buys his stuff from you, does he?
Look, man, this is way, way over my head.
Tough old game, crack dealing, isn't it?
I wouldn't know.
Yeah. You have to be very stupid or very wily to set up on your own as a crack dealer. Could be done, I suppose, but then you'd need to find your own source for the raw materials.
I'm telling you, man, you ain't got nothing on me.
Thompson's your source, isn't he?
Thompson supplies you with the cocaine, you turn it into crack. That way the other dealers are none the wiser. Well, we're right, aren't we? Fine, have it your own way. You just better pray that Thompson's covering your back as well as you're covering his. I take it you've nothing further to say.
No comment.
Any joy, Gus?
It's not working.
Well, we're not finished yet. Sit down, please. Interview with Edward Thompson. Officers present are DC Carver and WPC Croft. Interview commences at 10:13. Now, I have to remind you, Mr. Thompson, that you're still under caution. You do not have to say anything unless you wish to do so, but what you say may be given in evidence now. Do you understand?
I can't think why you want to interview me, Mr. Carver.
Okay. Tell me about Elliot Floyd. Have you known him long?
Dunno, a few months.
He's a good mate of yours, is he?
Yeah, he's all right. I mean, they're a good crowd when you get to know them. And they know some wicked clubs.
As you're such good mates, I assume you know something about their drug-related activities.
Look, what they do on that score is their business. I only go along for the music.
Oh, so you hang around with Floyd and his mates and you know nothing about crack?
10 pints of lager and a packet of crisps. That's my lot. And the odd spliff now and again, of course.
Of course. Okay. Try and see it from my point of view. We come across you in a crack dealer's flat and your excuse is you're there on a social visit. Now, if you were me, would you believe that?
No, I don't suppose I would. But that's me all over. Wrong place at the wrong time.
So, you're not a crack user, but you are a mate of Floyd who is a known crack dealer. I suspect you're more than a mate. In fact, I would go as far as to say you're a business partner.
How do you mean?
Oh, you supply the raw materials, Floyd does the rest. It must be working for a living.
You think I'm going to risk putting my job on the line by becoming a crack dealer?
Well, if it was worth it, I don't see why not.
Oh, come on.
Your job's obviously very important to you, Eddie. Presumably your employer doesn't know you're here.
Of course not. I mean, there's no reason for him to find out, is there?
No, not at all. You could always say you had an urgent dental appointment.
Dental appointment? Yeah, nice one.
Is it far from here where you work?
No.
So where is it exactly?
It's in the city. Look, I don't see what this has got to do with anything.
Oh, I'm just curious, that's all. So what exactly do you do for a living?
If you must know, I buy and sell futures, okay, for a merchant bank.
Oh, I get it now. The nice clothes, the expensive flat, the nice watch. So why do you spend most of your spare time slumming it on the Larkman estate?
I'm no snob. I told you, Elliot and his crowd are a good bunch.
Oh, I'm sure they are. A bit more happening than your colleagues at the bank, maybe.
You could say that.
How long have you lived in this area, Mr. Thompson?
Long enough to call myself a resident. Why?
And where are you from originally?
Haywards Heath, so what?
Well, correct me if I'm wrong, but I wasn't aware that the Cockney accent stretched as far as Sussex.
Yeah, well, I pick up accents easily, I always have done.
Yeah, and presumably you lose it as soon as you step through the doors of the bank. I just realised all this time I've been barking up the wrong tree. I assumed you were a business partner of Floyd, but you're not, are you?
Of course not.
No. Well, in that case, I'm sorry we've had to keep you here for so long. Well, I've got no further questions. What about you, Susie?
No.
I could go then.
Yeah, if you want to. Oh. Of course, there's still that little matter of that dope we found on you.
What, you're going to charge me?
Well, that's about the size of it. But who knows, a couple of white lies here and there and your boss will be none the wiser. Mind you, these things do have a habit of slipping out. Interview terminated at...
Hold on. Look, don't switch that thing off.
Second thoughts?
Look, I'll help you if you help me, OK?
Well, I can't promise you anything, but I can certainly see what I can do.
That's a deal. Can we start again?
Where does Floyd keep his stash, Mr. Thompson?
Outside the kitchen window. There's an air vent. You wouldn't really notice it from the outside.
And who supplies the raw materials?
I've told you all I know.
Fine.
Gav? You don't suppose Jim's got some kind of personal grudge against this Thompson, do you?
Well, I don't see how he can. First time he set eyes on him was this morning.
It's just that it seems like he's flogging a dead horse.
Look, Jim's got his faults, haven't we all? But letting his feelings get in the way of the job, that's not one of them.
Have you ever done crack yourself?
Yeah. Once or twice.
Do you like sailing close to the wind, Mr. Thompson?
What?
Well, it seems to me you're leading a kind of a double life. On one hand, you've got a respectable job, and on the other, you like hanging out with the lowlifes. Now, what is it? The element of risk?
Look, I don't see what relevance this has
got with
anything.
Are you sure you've got nothing else to tell me?
I've told you all I know.
Is Floyd the only dealer you've ever bought it?
Oh, come on!
Ah, I see. You don't mind shopping Floyd because he's small potatoes. Well, this could be a very long dental appointment, Mr. Thompson. Oh, come on. I'm waiting, mate.
Okay. You look in my wallet. You find a minicab card. Scribble it on the back. There's a mobile phone number. You ring up. You place your order. They'll bring you anything you want. Crack, smack, coke the lot.
A courier service. Who's running it?
What more do you want?
I want the name of the guy who runs it!
It's a big black guy called Toby. Now, for God's sake, don't mention my name.
What, scar by the left eye?
Yeah, that's him. Now can I go?
Well, we've still got to discuss the charge of possession.
But I kept up my part of the deal.
We don't do deals, Mr. Thompson.
Oh, but you said...
All I said is I would see what I could do.
Gough, Thompson's just spilled his guts.
Good. What's he giving us?
The whereabouts of Floyd's crack and information on a drug courier service. It seems you just dial a number, place your order, and they deliver it right to your door.
Only what they deliver is neither deep pan nor thin and crispy. So, well, what made Thompson give us all this lovely information?
Well, he's some high flyer in the city, apparently. If his boss knew he'd spent even a morning in the nick, he'd be out on his ear. Jim used that to get him to cough.
There we go, Gov. Toby Lewis. Now, apparently Donna's already pulled this one out today. Tony Stamp and Dave Quinlan gave him a tug earlier.
Right, we better place an order then. Set up a pick-up point.
That's it, Mr. Lewis. Off you go.
OK, go. Are you all right?
Yeah.
Gav? I wouldn't like to think what this would do to their photocopier.
There you go. Hang on a minute.
DC Carver, Sunhill Police. Now, you weren't going to run away before I could give you a tip, were you?
Hey, come on! Let's keep it quiet, shall we? Oh.
And there's me thinking you found yourself a steady job.
Get stuff, copper. Ever up to the friendly cabbie? Yo! Elliot Floyd, innit?
Yeah, so what?
You grass me up, you police informer.
You got dead!
Oh, leave him alone!
Get him out of here! Get him out of here!
A large bag of crack was found in an air vent outside your kitchen. Have you anything to say about that, Mr. Floyd?
Took you long enough.
Have you any idea what the average sentence is for crack dealing?
I don't sell to kids.
I'm sure the judge will take that into account.
What do you mean you don't sell to kids?
Look, it's not only black kids running around council estate use this stuff, you know. It's other people.
Like Thompson?
Yeah.
Is that why he was hanging around your flat early this morning?
Amongst other things.
Does he supply you with the raw materials?
Uh-uh.
Who does?
Oh, come on, man. I don't grass people up.
How very honourable of you.
I mean, what do you think you were doing, Elliot? Cornering a little niche in a market?
I wasn't going to do it for long. Just seemed like an easy way to make monies, that's all. People like Thompson have got more monies than sense. Why shouldn't I take some of it off them?
Because when push comes to shove, the Thompsons of this world win hands down. Every time.
Interview terminated, 11:28.
Edward Thompson, you were arrested earlier this morning for possession of controlled drugs, and you have admitted to the charge. However, in the circumstances, we have decided to caution you. Do you agree to this caution?
Yeah.
If you'd like to sign the form, please.
Something amusing you?
I'm only smiling, officer.
I trust we won't be seeing you here again. But I must warn you that if we do, I can promise we won't be so lenient. Here, a bit of light reading for you.
You're too kind.
Tight rags like you give decent villains a bad name.
You got a problem, officer.
Well, you could say that, yes.
You know, I'll do something about that chip on your shoulder, Mr. Carver.
Hi, Mr. Thompson. If you would like to sign there for your possessions.
Cheers. I was wondering, do you think I could make a quick phone call?
Yeah, I don't see why not, as long as it's quick. Do you want me to see him out in his dungeon?
Nothing would make me happier.
All right, Thompson. All right, it's me, Eddie. Listen, you never guess where I've been all morning. Go on, guess.
The way you were having a go at Thompson, I thought you really had it in for him.
What makes you think I didn't? All that matey business. Patronising little git.
Yeah, but without him, we wouldn't have got a result.
It's not that. It's just... Well, scum like him, they'd stitch their own granny up if they thought it would get him out of a corner.
Yeah. Well, you never know. Maybe a couple of hours at Sunhill will have taught him the error of his ways.
I doubt it.